Skelton hour, 614, take one.
CBS presents this program in color.
From Television City in Hollywood.
The Red Skelton Hour. Be a sport. Come and train your eyes on the happy games we design.
We'll resort to an exercise that'll take a load off your mind.
We can fool you over with lots of fun if you catch any one of our shows.
You should get your kicks from the jokes tonight, and we hope they'll be right on the nose.
Our guest star, Robert Goulet.
Thank you very much, and good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I feel good. Hey, but how about that weather, huh? Especially back east. Those poor kids back there, they'll have to do what the kids do out here in California now. They'll have to stay home and make smog man. I feel good tonight. You know what I've been doing? I've been doing my Christmas shopping. And those department stores, I'll tell you, I love to go to see the little kids talk to Santa Claus, you know. And everybody's got the Christmas spirit, you know. Pedestrians here, you get hit by a car, they don't run over you anymore. They say, Merry Christmas, and then go on. I saw a guy up on the freeway have an accident, and the ambulance came, and the doctor jumped out, and he looked at the guy, and he said, you got a broken leg. You want that wrapped as a gift? You know, the Christmas spirit really fills your heart, but it sure empties your pocketbook. You know, but I got to tell everybody on the show while I have the opportunity, remember, it's better to give than to receive. So you know what that means, fellas. This year again, Monogram toothpicks. And you know who I feel sorry for? David Rose. He's got 36 musicians. You know what he did last year? He bought every one of them a $10 tie, and they all chipped in and bought him one. Hey, you're a little kid talking to Santa Claus. Little kid talking to Santa Claus. He says, boy, Santa Claus, you sure got a good sense of humor, you know. He says, last year I said to you, I want something I can pet. Something that I can share with all the kids in the neighborhood. Something that'll crawl all over me and I can call Spot. And you did it. I got chicken pox. Let me tell all the little kids in the audience, you had better always believe in Santa Claus. Because a strange thing happens if you ever stop believing in Santa Claus. When Christmas comes, instead of dolls, games, and toys, you start finding under the tree socks, shirts, and underwear. Hey, good little kid. Two more kids are talking. One of the kids says, I just wrote a letter to Santa Claus, but I think I'm going to have a pretty lousy Christmas because all I can spell is rat, cat, hat, and bat. The other kid says, well, all I know about that old bloodshot blimp is that he brings you things according to how good you have been. The other kid says, really? Boy, I got a feeling all I'm going to find in my sock this year is my foot. For my friends back in Washington, D.C., I'd like to do a little Christmas poem. A little Christmas poem. It was the night before Christmas, and all over the land, the politicians were wondering about the election at hand. Come, Bobby, come, Romney, come, Dark Horse, come, Reagan. For which one of you boys are the voters digging? At night they sat by their Christmas trees, both the Democrats and the GOP. There's one fact that they're willing to relate, that their Santa Claus won't come till November 68. Now, to keep in the idea of the Christmas thing, I would like to do a little pantomime now around the Christmas time, you know, when everybody's full of the Christmas spirit and some guys, they get it in them and they drink it. Well, I'd like to give you my impression. I play two parts. I play the fellow making the eggnog. Give me my hat. The fellow play. I don't need that. The fellow making the eggnog and his cat.
When holidays are in the air, you sense it everywhere. You can hear it. See it. Feel it. Smell it. And now you can taste it a delicious new way. New Reynolds Aluminum Tapper puts real draft beer right in your own refrigerator. With Tapper, there's nothing to assemble, no attachments. You can take it right to your table. Tapper helps make every gathering more festive, lets you draw big ones or little ones. And long after the party, Tapper still keeps beer brewery fresh, glass after glass, week after week. Tapper comes in its own handy carrying case wherever cold packaged beer is sold. So enjoy holiday refreshment every day with your favorite brand of draft beer in Tapper. For a booklet on Tapper accessories, write Reynolds Aluminum, Richmond, Virginia.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, our guest star, Robert Goulet.
If you hear music when she's near you, and Christmas comes every day of the year, well, then you must know why. It's the first clue to the moment of truth is near. If every time she glances your way, a million bells start to ring loud and clear, and after one kiss you yell mayday, why then the moment of truth is near. There will come a day when she looks at you, thrills you through and through, and calls your name. That'll be the day when you say I do, 'cause you've discovered that you've grown tired of playing the game. And then you both know you're through scheming. Go, oh, promise me, starts to ring loud and clear. You're wide awake, boy, and you're not dreaming that. When she smiles like this and your single bliss goes out the door.
If it's all too late, who will share your kiss? You may consider losing your heart like never before.
And then you both know you're not scheming. Oh, promise me starts to ring loud and clear. You're wide awake, boy, and you're not dreaming. Cause when you say I do,
Red Skelton as Deadeye and Robert Goulet in The Fastest Cuspidor in the West.
Yeah, this town is very lucky. It will be the setting of the very first Western motion picture ever to be made.
Right, A.C.
Thanks, D.C. Have you noticed, ever since we started looking for actors, everybody's been trying to get parts in our movie by hamming it up?
Yeah. Well, here comes Sheriff Deadeye. There's enough ham in him to be on the free lunch.
Whoa! Help! Help! Gadzooks! I've been shot! I was guarding the payroll, and they got me right between the Wells and the Fargo. Pardon me. Oh, I've been...
You know, he might really be dying. Nobody could act that bad.
Oh! Oh, I'm going. Put on my epitaph that I died in the key of G.
He may be dying to the key of G, but I bet he goes to H.
You're proud of that. We go through Pasadena, you know. Yeah. Oh, I'm going. Ooh, them spurs. Oh, I hear voices. I hear a voice.
Whose?
Mine. Ain't you paying attention? I can hear them angels' wings are flapping. This one must be coming by motorcycle. When I hear angels' wings, they sound like the real thing, you know, and I'm too young to go. Well, there's just a lot of things I ain't done yet.
Like what?
Oh, shut up. Well, for one thing, I haven't had my lunch, and I wouldn't want to enter them pearly gates with my tummy growling.
Sorry. There's no fun in my picture for a crooked sheriff. Sorry.
There ain't giggles? How about an honest sheriff? I play character parts too, you know. Yeah. Bartender, I had a tiresome journey, and I'd like to quench my thirst with a bag of milk.
I never heard of a bag of milk.
You never seen a cow? There you are. Well, here's to you. Up the lips and over the gums. Look out, stomach. Here she comes. How much did that thing pay, this job?
A bit part, or about a dollar.
I ain't gonna drink no milk for a dollar. You can put that right back in the cow.
Now, how can I put milk back in a cow?
Well, you slide it under and tell her to inhale. I don't know.
I hear you're casting a movie. I'm here for one of the extra parts.
You don't need any extra parts. You need to get by with the standard equipment.
Well, we can use a dance hall, girl. Can you can-can?
Oh, she must. I saw her in Walla Walla at Simon Simon's, right?
Yeah.
Are you so-and-so out?
Very well, oh. Let me see. Let me see a walk across the stage here, my dear. Thank you, that's very good. What are you doing? You turned it down! Deadeye, that megaphone is for instructions.
It is? I don't need instructions. Just put it up there, I'll read it, boy. I can remember a lot of things.
My dear, you have the job.
Oh! Thank you.
One moment, please. Here it comes again.
Right, A.C.
Go ahead.
Well, no wonder these producers make such lousy pictures. They're all worn out from the casting. Well, sir? Did I read that line slow enough for you, buddy? Yeah.
Go now, my dear. Yeah. See you later. Yeah. I'm sorry, Deadeye, there's no part in the picture for you.
Well, it's just as well, because I wouldn't know what to do to thank you. No, what we need is a funny friend.
A funny friend?
Mm-hmm. Yes, I want a strange-looking character with thick glasses, messy hair, crazy-looking hat. Somebody that laughs.
Well, what's everyone staring at me for? Haven't you been on Sunset Strip?
Yeah, but I never seen anybody like you, ma'am.
Hey! Huh? You're it!
I meant, that wasn't even planned.
No, he means a part in our picture.
Wait, you can't sign him for a Western part. He'd look awful on a horse. He's got a head like a tail.
Deadeye, you're trying to get rid of me so I can't be in this here picture, and you can get the part, and that's a no-good plot, Deadeye.
Well, I know that, but it's the best we could come up with.
Come on, DC, we gotta find us a leading man.
Right, AC.
Look, kid, showbiz ain't for you. Now, why don't you get married and raise a big family? I only ask one thing.
What's that?
That I get the pick of the litter.
Well, I guess I ain't home on the range because I just heard a discouraging word. I'll see you later.
I'll see you after.
Oh, boy, you're wearing them glasses on the wrong end.
All right, Deadeye, I'm going to be a little more careful.
Right out here.
I'll see you later.
Well, he never had an exit like that in Brigadoon, I'll tell you.
Yes, AC.
Boy, what a shocking name.
We're all set to shoot our Western picture. All we need is someone to play the part of our big hero like we advertised.
Yeah, AC, we want somebody that's tall, dark, and handsome.
Well, sir, I'll tell you, I'm tall and handsome in the dark.
We want a leading man that's slim and trim. Look at you, your stomach's hanging out in front.
Where do you want it to hang out from? Besides, it keeps the dust off my boots.
Our leading man not only has to be slim, he must also be an actor. Be able to register pain.
Pain? Oh, I can do that. Here goes. Watch this. Oh, ouch. Oh, it hurts. It hurts. I tell you, it hurts, Judy. Oh, it burns. It stings. It stings. Come to think of it, you know, all them Western stars sting a little, don't they?
Ow, my foot! Ah! Now you're overacting! Come on.
Idiot! Look at that hair. You can't see a foot in front of you.
I got yours, didn't I? Well, what do you know? It stopped raining.
You know what you've done? You just maimed my toe. You've maimed my toe. Now I got toe maimed.
What do you care about that, Deadeye? You got 9 left.
Yeah, but it's going to louse up my game when I play this little piggy went to market.
Well, now, aren't you just a little old for that?
Well, you name it, I'm too old for it.
Well, I guess it's time for business. You see, I'm in ladies' unmentionables.
No. Well, keep your coat buttoned, nobody'll ever know it. Why do you wear that long coat anyhow?
My pants aren't finished. I get a lot of bargains. I get a lot of bargains. Could I interest you maybe in a lady's nightgown?
You couldn't interest me in a man's nightgown.
Well, right this way, girls, right this way. We have here a sale on stockings. Yes, sir, when you walk, they run.
I'll tell you what I want. I'd like to see something different in bloomers.
I'll toss you for this one. Okay. Hey, you got it. You got it, boy. Throw that line at him again, will you, ma'am?
I'd like to see something different in bloomers.
So would your husband.
Say, these two-headed coins come in handy on jokes like that.
Do you think a corset would do anything for me?
Oh, yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am, you lace this here thing tight enough to make your eyes bulge.
Who wants bulging eyes?
Well, it's better than no curves at all.
Sticks and stones will break my bones.
And so will a tight old corset.
Wait a minute, man, wait a minute. This here corset will make you look trim and slim and neat and clean and dry.
There's an idea. I'll lace myself in one of those ladies' things. Sure, I wouldn't be the first star that ever wore a corset.
Corsets come high, did I?
That's what I need. High, low, and in the middle.
Well, if he doesn't come back, I can use this for a tennis net.
Boy, that thing is, that's really got a lot of stretch to it. That could go around Jackie Gleason from head to toe.
You want to put that on?
I'm going to put that thing on.
All right.
Look,
up.
Ain't that a dandy? Look at them watch fobs.
You got your pump in the right place.
And that thing's gonna make your stomach join it.
Oh, boy, I'll tell you, I can't breathe. No wonder women walk around with a nose in the air. They're trying to get a little oxygen there. Oh, boy, you know it takes a lot of guts to wear one of these.
Your stomach's gone. It's either that or it's leaking out of your back pocket.
You proud of that,
yeah.
Fine thing. Picture the shoot, we still haven't found our thin, trim, handsome leading man.
Well, there's certain things you just can't squeeze out of a corset.
I think that idea is mine.
Well, there's our leading man.
Me?
Look at that waist. That profile,
yeah,
those
yeah.
eyes, that chin.
Good, I can be a movie star and run for governor.
Congratulations, leading man. Here's your contract.
Why, you handsome rat. You ought to be arrested for carrying a concealed face.
Oh, now, don't feel too badly, Deadeye. Listen, I'll make you my agent. You get 10% everything I make.
No, yeah. Just about my luck, you get 7-year it.
Nothing. This is a take. Remember, you're playing General Custer. Now, as you make your entrance, pull out your sword.
Okay, crank them.
Roll them. Action!
Now?
Now! Get back and come back out again.
Well, gee, if you don't ask, how are you going to learn?
No! Cut! Cut!
With what?
Lousy acting. Where's your agent?
Oh, come on. If I can't find my sword, how am I going to find my agent?
Well, now, I'll ask you again, honey. Do you want to get in pictures?
How?
Well, we'll think of something. You run along now.
Yeah,
well, you've ruined the tent, so we'll move to the last scene of the picture.
Last scene of the picture. Custer's last stand.
Wait a minute. As the star of this here picture, I demand that you give me a 40-foot pool without water.
Without water? Why?
Well, I can dive, but I can't swim.
Well, I'm sorry, the pool's out. But I'll raise you to 5,000.
I'll take that.
You shake hands with your new star. I'm going to play this part of
Who place. Says you're my new star?
These two little fellows, Remington and Colt.
Yeah. Now, wait a minute. Now, Deadeye, what am I going to do?
Well, you're going to go through the audience and make sure that the Indians are sitting on feathers because we need all the laughs we can get. I like the way you don't throw things out on my line. And I told everybody back in Indiana how you waited for them.
Would you like to put this here on?
Yeah, I'll put this on.
Okay, I'll give you this thing, too.
Well, where's my harp? Oh, I see. Here.
Why don't you try?
try putting it around your chest.
Boy, you're a little Dickens, ain't you?
Okay, all you phony Indians, get on the set.
I'll get
ready for the massacre scene.
Okay, AC, I'm sorry to have to tell you this, but I'm taking over as a director.
Huh?
Who says? Well, I says because of the letter I'm writing to your wife about last night at the Cactus Gulch Hotel.
Oh, no, wait a minute. That was my wife.
Well, then I'm going to write it to your girlfriend.
That's your bitch.
Okay, folks, now when General Custer comes on, I want you to go to the scalping scene just the way you rehearsed it, right? My goodness, here come some real Indians. Holy Mohicans.
Deadeye! Deadeye, who makes troops with my daughter? Deadeye!
What's the matter with you guys? Wait till Gold Custer gets out here.
I never saw such a phony bunch of Indians in all my life. What'd you use, roll-on paint?
Don't insult us. We Blackfeet Indians.
I've seen Blackfeet Indians, but not all the way up to the hips.
Yeah, not 30.
No, then how come every time you take a swim in the lake, you leave a ring around it? That's a good one, huh? That's a good one.
Here, now. That wasn't the way we rehearsed this. Now, all you're supposed to do is just scalp me, that's all.
That's just what we have in mind.
Well, if you're going to scalp me down there, you better use a tummy hook.
Wise guy. Want to tell Indian where to scalp.
Here now.
Oh, wait a minute. Cut! I mean, don't cut.
Please.
See, these are... They're Indians.
There's hair under there, buddy.
They're bloodthirsty Indians.
Bloodthirsty? I'm going to act with them. I ain't going to buy them a drink.
You don't understand that. They're not actors.
I know that. They're pretty lousy, but they're trying.
Don't you understand? They're braves.
Are you kidding? Atlanta never had a team like this.
Ted, I'm not kidding. I mean, you know, that scalping knife is set for crew cut.
Yeah?
They're real Indians.
They are?
Yeah.
How many in the tribe?
$3 and the chief.
Which one's the chief?
The one with the $3. It'll be fast.
I've been planning on that one all day.
You're crazy or something. I hired all these Indians myself. That's Hank, Joe, Bill, and Charlie.
Yeah. Hi, Hank. Hi, Joe. Hi, Bill. Charlie? Let me see that rubber knife. Ooh. Oh, they're real Indians. Let's see inside your mouth. My golly, they're red inside, too.
Just take a sniff, did I? You smell buffalo in his breath.
Boss?
I count three. We stab.
Wait a minute.
Now, Deadeye, you finished the picture, right?
Yeah.
You're the star of the country's first movie company.
Yeah. 19th Century Fox has done it again.
Fool!
I like the way you waited for the laugh there. It didn't come.
They turn the spotlight on you, Deadeye. The crowd applauds. Now, what are you going to do?
They throw a light on me and the crowd applauds. What do I do? I stumble through the Star Spangled Banner.
I knew I'd get that in there.
I knew you'd get that in there.
I bow.
Three! Well, Custer did it again.
Oh, now, wait a minute, Dada. You can't do this to history. You can't have Custer's last stand ending with a happy ending.
You can't?
No.
Well, what difference does it make? 100 years from now, they'll show this on television, and this scene you'll have to cut for the last commercial. You never know the difference.
I'd like to know one thing. Can you tell me why it is in a Western movie that all the actors, all the cowboys, ride off the last scene into the sunset?
But to get their checks, the cashier's just over the hill. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we'd like for you to meet a very dear friend, our guest, and he's very talented gentleman, Mr. Robert Goulet. He says I almost had a pump attack waiting to get on. Oh, thank you very
much.
That's
quite all
right. I got enough dander for bread of veal cutlet there. Say, you know, I'd like to ask you one question.
Okay.
How did a guy like you ever get to marry such a beautiful, talented girl like Carol Lawrence? She is a good singer, and she's just a wonderful actress.
Well, she's also a pretty good cook.
Oh.
And she's a real mother.
Yeah.
You know, we have two little babies now. And besides that, after two babies, you mustn't underestimate her dancing, because she's pretty agile still yet, you know. She can kick herself in the head.
Maybe that's what helped you, I mean. No. Hey, and I understand another thing, that one of your hobbies is collecting things.
Yeah, I'm very proud of my art collection and my record collection.
Well, I'm glad to hear that, because I've got something for you.
Have you?
I write music, and I have an album out. I have two albums now, and I paint, and I've got something for you. There's the album, and there's one of the paintings.
You're kidding me.
There.
Isn't that lovely?
Yeah.
Well, thank you very much, Red.
By golly, if you're that kind, I'll cut the price down to $500.
$500 what?
$500.
$500?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Oh, Red, you're...
I'm making that cheap because the people kind of like...
Yeah, that's the word. You're cheap.
Well, if you don't want to add it to your
collection...
No.
I'm going to take it because you know, collecting is a marvelous hobby, hobby. You want to try collecting a few things.
I think I will.
Yeah, I'll see you later, okay?
But wait a minute. How about my $500?
Well, that's the first thing you should try to collect.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Robert Goulet.
Chance to say, let your hearts be gay, now that Christmas Day will be here.
End of September, when life was slow and oh so mellow. Try to remember the kind of September when grass was green and grain was yellow. Try to remember the kind of September when you were a tender and callow fellow. Try to remember, and if you remember, then follow. Except the willow. Try to remember when life was so tender, the dreams were kept beside your pillow. Try to remember when life was so tender that love was an ember about to billow. Try to remember, and if you remember, then follow. Deep in December, it's nice to remember, although you know nice to remember, without a hurt, the heart is hollow. Deep in December, it's nice to remember the fire of September that made us mellow. December, our hearts should remember and follow, 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 follow.
Now the Silent Spot, starring Red Skelton. Tonight, we take you to a department store where we find out what happens when a crotchety old salesman who doesn't like children is transferred to the toy department. Red Skelton in 'Tis the Season to be Jolly. Thank you. Go away, Red will be back in a minute. Here he is again, Red Skelton.
Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of our sponsors and staff, we sincerely hope that our entertainment and our products have brought happiness into your homes. And remember, your merchants are not trying to make Christmas commercial. They merely want to remind you of things that you can get to other people to ease your thinking. Good night, and may God bless.
Clear the track, cause we have to run.
And relax our tired physiques.
We'll be back with a lot more fun after resting up for a week. So goodbye until the moment when we'll see you all again. To our friends near and far,
this is Art Gilmore speaking.